Well, hello everybody, welcome to JCPW Warfare. It is Jordan Collins, your host and your general manager and commentator, and we are live from Florence, Italy for tonight's show. And we've got a very special show because we've got a rematch happening from last night, from the last episode of JCPW. So don't watch JCPW. We had a match where we saw, well, I'll get onto that, what we saw in a little bit, right before our presenters, because we're opening our first match. Hand you over to our ring announcer.
Making his way to the ring from Brisbane, Australia, weighing in at 238 pounds, Outlaw Eddie Geary.
That is right, Eddie Geary. Superstar been on a little bit of a losing streak as of recently, but can he pull through with a big win tonight to get himself back on track? Because let's be honest, he hasn't had the best start as of recently to his career in JCPW. But like I say, it is a very special show tonight because we have got a massive main event coming up for you. And I will tell you about that as the match goes on, but we're going to hold to our next competitor. Here he is. Danger Show coming to the ring. But like I say, tonight is a very special show tonight because we have a rematch from one of our matches from JCPW. So those who've been watching us recently, we have been holding a tag team tournament to determine new tag team champions since the current tag team champions have vacated the titles for other reasons that we do not speak with. But we will see the Anarchists taking on the Hooligans in a rematch, semi-final rematch, because for those who watch JCPW, that match ended in a very controversial count-out. And believe me, the Hooligans were not happy with that result. So they came to me, they asked, and they really, they genuinely did plead with myself here and management to remake that match and have it rematched, and we will see that later on tonight. But we're going to see our match, obviously, Danger Cho there reversing that fisherman suplex attempt into a Northern Lights, and now Cho going in for the crucifix pin, early attempt on that pin. Now these both guys have not had the best of results as of recently, but can this be the turnaround? Can this be the chance for them to turn it around? Just have to wait and see. Oh, comes up there, I've used huge clothesline. Drops over with a leg drop to the back of the neck. And he's going to the top, now Eddie Geary's going up to the top. What are we going to see? There's a big elbow drop there. Now this is going to be a big win for any one of these guys, because wins do matter here in Warfare. Reversal there from Eddie Geary. Now both these guys are lower end down our power rankings here. Oh, big shot there. They're both, big shot goes into the pin. Is it the pin one? No. Both guys are the bottom end of our power rankings because they haven't had the best of win-loss records here in JCPW. So this is a chance for them to get up there, and I see Eddie Geary just driving the point of the elbow across the nose. Now Eddie Geary looking to him, but he's reversed. Danger Cho drives him face first into the mat and stomps on the back of his neck. And draws it with a knee drop there. So we have got a packed show for you. As you see, Danger Cho rolling to the outside, trying to gather his breath, but Geary straight out through him, catches him with a forearm. And a bionic elbow there. Eddie Geary needs to take advantage of this. Eddie Geary needs this win Same as Danger Chode. Although Chode does have a victory, Eddie Geary has yet to win anything. As he, oh, driving him face first into that apron there, right at the bottom. Referee, that's with a five count. Geary throws back in his opponent. Here we go, back in the ring. Strike. I've knocked my shoulder, but you can see an 8 second ride. Huge 8 second ride there. Usually it lines up for that last call super kick. Are we going to see Ira's last orders? Bell is ringing. There it is. Last orders. Door closed. This match could be over. Eddie Geary going for the pin. One. Two. Oh, Dave Cho just gets that shoulder up there. So not quite last orders yet for Danger Cho. And Cho there with a reversal kick to the face. And Geary rolls to the outside. That's a wise thing or not, I don't know. That's Cho. Oh, definitely wasn't. There you go. Cho sent to the outside with a forearm. Eddie Geary now and Cho on the outside. Cho does have control. Driving face first into the steel steps. To the gap by elbow from Geary, who sends Cho back into the ring. Both guys back now in the ring. Geary has him up for a teardrop suplex. Excuse me, bit of a burp on that one. Oh, what's this? Oh, it stomps on. He does know Cho likes to utilize that lariat. He's trying to take that with a stomp to the arm. Geary in full control of this match right now. Straight stops in the midsection and a straight forearm to the face. Eddie Geary's in control. Oh, there is commentator's curse. Mishinoku driver there from Danger Cho. Clothesline. Show off the clothesline a second. And comes up with a follow the third huge lariat there from Danger Cho. We're gonna see it. Discus clothesline. This could be it. Lariat. Oh! No, doesn't get the pin off the lariat. Of the discus lariat. Cho is gonna try and finish this one off now. Has him up. Yuroshoten. Got the pin. One, two. Oh, lackadaisical pin. Danger Cho with that, with the drop zone. Another one. 8 second ride from Eddie Geary. Eddie Geary now back in control of this match. Drags Cho to the middle of the ring. Goes the pin is one, two. No, again, only it's Eddie Geary. Shocked at that one. I think this audience were as well. He's gonna go for another last orders. Last orders! Spins Cho inside out with that one. Oh, but that momentary lapse, could that be, is that gonna cost him? One, two, three. Oh, that was close. That momentary pull, where he pulls him to the middle of the ring, might have been enough time to give Cho a chance to recover. As Eddie Geary gaining himself, Cho is out on his feet. Talking a little bit of trash to his opponent, drops him down the reverse DDT. Eddie Geary looking spent now, but has he got enough left to finish this match off? Oh, Codebreaker! Is that going to be enough off the Codebreaker? One, two, three. Again, Cho able to kick out. Like I said, gentlemen, Danger Cho. Showing some major resilience. He's had two last orders. And now a Codebreaker, several shots to the face, but still not enough to keep Danger Cho down. As you see now, Eddie Geary trying to wear his opponent down. Cho onto his feet, out to the midsection, and a second. Releases the hold. Strike to the head. And an Irish whippy, what we're going to see here from Joe! Super kick of his own! Big super kick there. Goes to the pin, our referee, his feet on the road, I think referee noticed that then. Danger Cho trying to take a shortcut, not like him. Reversal, Eddie Geary, knee, big huge strike to the knee. Strike to the foot, knee strike to the head there. We're going to work it out. Goes to the chop, was reversed. And gets caught with a side-o suplex. Backdrop driver there. Show now in for the pin off that back suplex. Two, nope, not enough. Think it's going to be more than that to keep Eddie Geary down. Because he has hit another level tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Here you go, Cho. Oh, there's a huge Lariato there. Lariato! Now Cho's not afraid to fly with the beautiful moonsault. But that's taking a little bit out of him, Cho trying to gain himself. Gain composure. Goes to the separate, reversed. Eddie Geary now in control with the beautiful spine buster there. Are we going to see another one of those last orders? Goes for, no, misses it that time. Cho is ready for it. And then catches him with a dragon whip there. Dragon whip kick. Danger Cho now in control, using the power. Oh, ooh, combination there, driving Geary into the turnbuckle and then face first into his knee. Cho looking to get something going, but Eddie Geary able to reverse that one. Kicked that midsection. And he's going on that arm again, stomping on that arm, trying to take out that lariat. One, two, no, not enough. Eddie Geary now needs to finish this one off, and his repeated elbows to the face there. But Cho able to reverse it. Kicks his opponent down to the mat and works over the leg. Elbows drop to the leg there. And into the Indian deathlock. Oh no, just crank back on the up. Geary getting to his feet. Are we going to see another one? Has him up. This is the power. Yura Shoten. This could be done. One, two, three. Danger Cho picks up the victory. Yet another loss for Eddie Geary. What would it take for this guy to catch a break? Great win there for Danger Cho. I know. What's happening here? Oh, show a sportsmanship there, shaking at the hands. Eddie Geary beaten by the better guy there, and willing to admit that. Congratulations to Danger Cho. But ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a really short commercial break. We'll be right back after this one. So like I said, we're taking a real short commercial break. We'll be right back after this.
As the fire of the movement fades away, a new blazing entity shall rise from its ashes. And with it comes a molten battleground. An inferno where gladiators and evil monsters shall duel. Titans will clash with warriors. The strength of the gates will be tested, and worlds will collide. As a chapter closes, a grander one begins. This is the birthplace of a new era. This is our inception. enjoying the show? Head over to our GogBox page where you can support Star Team and even purchase a Unite membership for I still can't believe this, for free!
And welcome back, everybody. Can't wait for Inception, but we're going to go on to your next match of the evening. And this is going to be two upcoming tag teams here in JCPW.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, accompanied by the innovator, Jay Stone, and representing Havoc from Aberdeen, Scotland, weighing in at 232 pounds, AJax.
That is right, representing Havoc, that is AJax there. Yes, so we've got two upcoming tag teams going at it here. But it's not a tag team, it's single matches, but it's two very upcoming tag teams. I've got a very bright future here in JCPW, without a doubt. So we've got one half, that is AJax from Havoc, and their opponents. That is right, representing the Maniacs, this is Zack. Now Zack Slater had a massive showing against Daniel Storm on the last episode of JCW for the Hardcore Championship. And I gotta be honest, I was impressed by Zack Slater. And then Brody Bishop did put up a good fight as well in the qualifying match for the Ascension to Gold match. But here we go, we're gonna see Zack Slater in singles action. But their tag team partners aren't far behind. Let's see how this one goes. Again, two superstars looking to make an impact. AJax. Zack Slater. Bell goes, here we go, both guys. Tie up in the middle of the ring. A little bit of chain wrestling to start yourself off with. Ooh, cheeky little shot to the face. The only AJax was up with a flying crossbody. Didn't take kindly to that. Goes in. Oh, belly to belly suplex. AJax now in one in control. Stomps to the back of the head. Slater rolls to the outside. Oh, goes to try and pull him out, but AJax ready for it. Forearm strike. AJax is in. Oh, folding up there with a back suplex. I know, slowing the match down, goes back to that front face lock. Cranking back on it. Weakening as a tiring down his opponent. This isn't a submission, it's just to weaken his opponent, slow them down. Because Zack Slater does like to fly, he is the speed of the Maniacs. Oh, it kips up. AJax just steps out the way. Oh, has him up, he's going to hit a big... Oh, the butterfly pile driver. It is an elbow shot, this elbow strike for me from Zack Slater, who falls out with a side-o suplex. Killer cross style side-o suplex there. Now in control, Zack Slater turns the match around with that suplex, snaps back and a kick to the back of the neck there. Oh, we've seen this more of a few times before. Twist the arm and snaps it down. I'm going to return the favour, AJax there. Oh, and biting on the referees. Biting on the fingers of AJax there. Of Zack Slater. I think pulling back on the nose, just rakes the eyes. Has him up with a just throws him face first. Wheelbarrow face buster almost there. AJax in control. Has him up with a sit out suplex. Sit out powerbomb, sorry. AJax blasting in his work right now. Really has the upper hand on his opponent right now. Is it the pin? One. No, he gets a one count. Clearly not enough yet. AJax now stalking his opponent. Still in control with a DDT. AJax looking good for the discus clothesline. Folds his opponent inside out with that clothesline. AJax is in full control. Zack Slater rolling to the outside. Trying to get a respite, but is that wise? With a person like AJax, not at all. Shoulder tackle, shoulder charges him off the apron, onto the mat. Has control, throws him in to back into the ring. AJax now looking to fly. Goes to an elbow to the small of the back. AJax has been in full control of this match. Goes into the pin. Is that going to be enough for the elbow drop? One. Two. No, only a two count. Zack Slater's in trouble. The rapid fire knees to the mids, to the chest there. Zack Slater is in a lot of trouble right now. AJax has been all over him right now. As him up. Oh, we see him to this one. Yosaka Cutter! Chico DDT, but no. Brody Bishop break up the count. Hits him with the code breaker there. And we're going to rename it. That's going to be the virus. Hits him with the virus. And then snap mares him down. And there's an elbow to the top of the head. Well, ladies and gentlemen, for those who are watching, if you've got any names for the finishes up that you're seeing used, please let me know. Drop me in the comments, drop me a message, drop me a tweet to name some of these finishers. Now we see a snap neck breaker there. Zack Slater is looking good. Wounds up a forward clothesline and a second one. Ducks under and gets the power slam. Snaps him over with the power slam. Zack Slater now has him up on the shoulders. There is Death Valley Driver. Slater looking to finish this off with a huge curb stomp. Drives AJax's face into the mat with a pin. One, two. Oh, again, so close on the count there. Not enough to keep AJax down. Just basking in the crowd there. Zack Slater showing off the crowd a little bit, showing off athleticism off. And followed with a hook kick. Talking about a momentum shift. Slater now in control. Rolls through. With the Eerie Crash. Eerie Crash neckbreaker. And then goes back to that arm. Snapping it down. As you can see. AJax's tag team partner feeling that one too. AJax with an exploder. Exploder suplex out of nowhere. AJax now in control. Irish whip to the top turnbuckle. Follows up with a body splash there. And into the bottom one. Stomp to the face. Oh, we've seen him do this one before. That beautiful running knee. That could break his damn nose. But it looks like AJax feeling it after that. Trying to catch a breath. But here we go. Are we going to see another virus? We're going to see the virus code. Virus Code DDT! Oh, we've got a bleeder! But no, Zack's able to kick out of that one. AJax now in control. And looking good while he does it. Oh, clothesline. And another one. Throws under for another Superman clothesline. Hits the comeback. Slater now in trouble. Nice to see that. Gets reversed. Oh, STO! Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we've got to say we've got the bleeder. Both guys busted open. A bloody fight here. What a fight we're seeing. Back and forth from both these tag teams. AJax, Irish whip into that top turn, but the bottom of the knee. Slater gets straight back to his feet, almost with the clothesline, but he's caught. Oh, drags him into the turnbuckle with a cut with the clothesline. And a blatant choke there. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Can AJax finish this off now? Goes in for the pin. One, two, only a two count. Can AJax finish this match off? Again, it's those repeated knees to the chest. AJax is looking good. Oh, here we go. Third time. Virus code! That could be it. It's one, two, three! He's done it. A massive win for AJax there. But what a match. What a show by both guys. Okay. But look at the bloody mess that is AJax right now. And Zack Slater as well. Show of respect for both guys there. Both guys busted open. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to AJax. Two tag teams to look out for, ladies and gentlemen. But ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take another short commercial break. We'll be right back after this one. And we are back with you one more time, gentlemen. We're going to move on to our next match. This is going to be a good one. One of my favourite stars here in JCPW at the moment. I mean, and he is a current entrant into the Ascension 2 Gold match coming up for you in about 2 or 3 weeks' time. And you know what? He qualified for that in a fantastic Fatal 4-Way Elimination match on JCPW last episode. And let's be honest, still has one of the best entrance tracks you can go for. But it's Baby Nettle. Can't go wrong with that one. But Kushida here to Now, why does it show why he deserved that spot? And he does have a tough task ahead of him, because he is taking on a very tough competitor. He is taking on the former and first ever JCPW Warfare Champion, Peter's Akira. Now, we know Peter's Akira has not been right since his brutal match against Gabriel for the Warfare Championship, which he did come up short to, and so he is former. But that is not going to mean a thing to Kushida. He just wants to prove why he deserves a spot in that Ascension to Gold match. This is the perfect opportunity to do it. Here we go. His opponent for the match. That's right, Peter's Akira. Now, Peter's Akira has not been right since his loss. I mean, Gabriel went through a brutal three stages of hell match. I mean, it was brutal. First match was a blood feud match, because the whole point that is to bust your opponent open. And then after the match, they still went on for two more matches. I mean, absolutely brutal. And he's not been the right since, to be honest. That kind of conflicted, not really picking up victories, not being 100%. There's been a confliction with Peter's Akira, like, taking these shortcuts or anything like that, why he should do it. It's a bit of a weird situation. I'm not too sure what is going on with Peter's Akira at the moment. But here we go. Kushida versus Akira. And Peter's Akira starts off with the strikes. And draws him out with a short end brainbuster. Now, we've seen a side to Peter's Akira I didn't think existed. I see him taking advantage there, but Kushida there catches him there off guard there with that beautiful Hurricane Rana. But I see we've seen a side of Akira I didn't think existed, to be honest. Standing shooting star from Kushida. He seems conflicted. Ever since his match against Gabriel, he's not been his usual self. You see a beautiful bow and arrow lock there. He's not been himself. Akira seems conflicted, you know, about things he's doing in the ring and outside the ring. There's a step up Enziguri here. See what you see now, this is the Peter's Akira we have come to know. Again, joint manipulation, working on the body parts, technical wrestling, and again, another one of those bow and arrow locks. But he just can't seem to string a win together since losing his belt. As he drops down with a DDT, it's a pin, he's one, oh, not even a two count there. But this is the side, I mean, like, this arrogance that he has. He switches all of a sudden. Like, there's all sense on the outside. I went. Again, that momentary pause. But, see, this is what I mean. He has this, like, this, for no reason. That is not Peter's Akira. There we go, one. He'll have these moments where he'll, you know, he's. He fight fair, a technical wrestler, and then we see this side of this arrogance. But Kushida wasn't happy with that. Catching the rolling forearm. Now in control, stomping on the leg. And Kushida now has him up for a vertical suplex. Kushida now taking control of this match. Suplex into that inverted reverse DDT. And then a stomp to the midsection. This is the power, the deceptive strength he has. Gut wrench into the power bomb. Deadlift gut wrench power bomb. And this is the other side of Kushida. He's not afraid to fly. What are we gonna see? Phoenix Splash! Huge Phoenix Splash there from Kushida. now has control of the match, drops in. Oh, with the Northern Lights rolls through. Use that core straight into a final cut. Spinning neck breaker there. Oh, this is the move I'm looking forward to. Check this out, roll through, there it is! Dragon with Enziguri. And stuck, followed the standing shooting star press. Don't know why he didn't go for the pin straight away off that. Here he goes to the pin, there's one. No, he get, oh, he didn't get one count there. Maybe he should have gone for the pin earlier. But I love that Dragon with Enziguri. Oh, we're going to see it again. Rolls under, here we go, whips out, Dragon Whip! Dragon Whip Enziguri. Is that going to be enough to keep Akira down? Referee's in one, two. Oh, Akira just gets that shoulder up. The thing is, the total of Akira, this new side of him, it does help him. It gives him a new resiliency. A side of him that you wouldn't expect to see. Kushida is going to the top, going to fly again. Shooting star press, oh, this, oh, what the hell was that? Shooting star press, Akira gets the knees up, but that has no effect, as Kushida kicks straight back up. He's going to do it again, Northern Lights, uses that core, follows through into a beautiful twisted neck breaker there. Is that going to be enough in the pin? One, two, oh, again, only a two count. Peter's Akira is looking, is showing some resiliency, but Kushida's looking even better. Kick to the face, Akira's back in. Oh, what, wait a minute. No, bro, Akira just got himself purposely disqualified? So this is the side I don't understand, like, why? Why would you do that, Akira? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a short commercial break.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Paul All-Stars.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. You've seen that seeing is believing. Your ears and your eyes will be bleeding. Please check to see if you're still breathing. Do you want it? Do you need it? Let me hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, do you want it?
And welcome back, everyone. We're gonna get started straight away because you know right now the music. That is the music of our JCPW Warfare Champion. That is Gabriel. Let's see what he's got to say. I'm intrigued because this guy is twisted. Gotta be honest, that is very, very correct. This guy is so unpredictable. I mean, this guy will hit you out of nowhere, can take you out of nowhere. I mean, he is dangerous. Oh, that makes sense. I mean, has Gabriel got in the head of Peter Sakura? That, for those who don't know, Tyson Black is the current number one contender, as Gabriel did say, for his Warfare Championship. And he wants, I don't disagree with what he's saying right now. This Gabriel is dangerous. Nails it right on the head there. Akira's not been right, but see what he's got to say. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. I have no idea what he just said at the end there. I think it might be in German, I don't know. Those who, if anybody can translate what he just said, please let me know. But some strong, strong, scary words there from Gabriel. But it is now main event time, ladies and gentlemen. Sit back, relax. Here we go with your main event. Like I say, this is a rematch from last episode of JCPW. At request. At request of the Hooligans. And they felt, the Hooligans of Tyler West and Razor Ray, felt they were robbed. And to be honest, I won't disagree. I mean, Lee Jacobs prevented Razor getting in the ring, threw him into the ring count, and rolled back into the ring while Razor was out on his feet. You can imagine the Hooligans were pretty unhappy with that one. And let's be honest, we don't want matches of that kind of caliber ending via a count out, but we're going to do it to ring announcer or their opponents.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 520 pounds, Tyler West and Razor Ray, the Hooligan.
I've got no issue with them asking for that rematch because, like again, I said, I wasn't particularly happy with that finish either. I'm glad they did come out, and to be honest, the Anarchists, reluctantly, I will say that, agreed to the rematch to happen here tonight on Warfare. So you're getting a good treat for you on this one, because the winner of this one will go through to the finals to face Fatality for those vacated tag team championships. But here we go, Lee Jacobs is going to start it off, Tyler West for the Hooligans, here we go. But Jacobs straight in there with the strikes. And then a tie up. Back to his opponent. Are we going to get a clean break? Yeah, we did. We got a clean break. Now West in control. Goes to the drop kick but misses it. Finds carry there from Tyler West with the reversal. Sends him into the corner, gets some tag team wrestling straight away. No! Jacobs reverses it and follows up with a single leg drop kick of his own. Dragging his opponent to their side of the ring. Tag team wrestling 101, tag team Tyler X. Now Tyler X, now the power of the team in the ring. But West reverses him. Irish up into their own corner. And they Razor Ray grabbing onto Rex then to get the knee shot in. What's that? Oh, drop kick. Tag to Razor. Here we go. Now Razor now has Tyler Rex in the ring. Dragging him center and just the closed fist punch to the top of the head there. And cranking back and using that power, really cranking on it there. Almost trying to rip his head off. Here we go, Razor throws him into the bottom, goes a body splash, but Rex has just managed to get out of the way. Punches in the midsection, falls up with an Irish whip into the turnbuckle. Oh, with a bit of force on that one. Rex now appealing to the crowd, maybe trying to get them behind him again, return the favor, cranking back on the head of Razor. trying to rip his head off too. Has control now. Goes to the wall, but no reversal there from Ray. Oh, falls over the clothesline. Razor now in control. Irish whip into the bottom turnbuckle. We're going to see some tag team wrestling from the Hooligans. There it is. Double axe handle to the arm. Rex reverses it. Has him up for Alabama Slam. Dragging him to his opposite corner, tags in Lee Jacobs. And Jacobs gonna work the arm, stamping back on that shoulder, jump manipulation, and these punches to the head. Cheap little kick at the end of it as well. Lee Jacobs now in control. Working the leg, drops down. Taking out the base of the quicker, lighter Tyler West is reversed. Tyler West reverses it. Tags out to Razor, but Jacob saw what was coming. Pop to the outside. Oh, sneaky there. Sneaky from Lee Jacobs. Goes a body splash, but misses it. And Razor throws him into the turnbuckle. Oh! Punched to the back of the head and then followed up with a clothesline. And this is the power. Has him up. Oh, no reversal there from Lee Jacobs. Into the crossbody. Now in control. Kick to the back. Lee Jacobs now in control of this one. Looking good. Irish whip into that top turnbuckle. Oh, we're going to see here. He's going to go for something big off the top rope. Oh, kick to the back. Great balance there. Kick, super kick to the side of the face. And then into that top turnbuckle. Oh, we've seen this one. Fire starter. There is the fire starter neckbreaker. Is it going to be enough? One. Oh, but no. Tyler West in there to break it up. Anarchists finishing that fire starter neckbreaker. Goes through it, snap suplex on Tyler Rex. Razor is in trouble. Tyler West is down. Irish whip into the top turnbuckle because he's in tag team, but no, Razor has enough to reverse it. Sends into his own corner. Some tag team move here now from the Hooligans. Double back body drop. And he's caught with a single knee. Single knee shot, hasn't it? One, two, but tight. Lee Jacobs just in there to break it up. But Razor finds him, throws him out of the ring. Oh, Tyler Ware's dabbing on his opponent. Moving you from. Well, are we going to see it? We saw earlier the bow and arrow lock. Beautiful move there. Slowing it down. Which is quite surprising considering Tyler West is all about speed. Here we go. Has him up on the shoulder. He's going to drop in neck first. Oh, that top rope. And then follows up with a power bomb. Oh, go West. We're going to see he's going to go for it. This is. Go West! There it is! Run Inseguri, go West! Go West and Inseguri, what we're gonna see is gonna try to finish it off. Has him up. Detonation kick. Is that gonna be enough? One, two, but no, Jacob breaks it up. Referee is out. And oh! Just slams it on the referee as well. Referee 2 has to recover from that. Oh, there's a short end brain buster. Jacobs and Razor going for it. West Rex is up. Has the point up on the shoulders. What a flapjack! Taylor Rex in control with the involved. There's that beautiful elevated elevated complete shot. Get wrecked, as he calls it. Tyler X now in control with get wrecked. Didn't go for the pin. Reversal. Tyler West goes to the knee. Irish whip and sends him into the bottom turnbuckle. We're going to see some tag team moves. Oh, hooliganism! There's the hooliganism. The magic is going to be enough. One, two, but no. Lee Jacobs again breaks it up. But Razor goes in for the pin again. One, two. Rex kicks out. Back and forth. Oh, nothing more there, but Tyler Rex gets the knee up. Yeah, Tyler Rex now in control. Sends him into the top. Are we going to see it again? Here it is. Firestarter neckbreaker. Is that going to be enough? In the pin. Jacobs in the pin. Is one, two, three. The Anarchists are going to Ascension to Gold for a shot at the JCPW Tag Team Championships. And they won that one clear. Look at this. Beautiful. Firestarter neckbreaker. There's the Go West. Running into Geary kick. And we even see the detonation there. Detonation kick. And there's the get wrecked. So many signature moves starting this one. And this is, we thought this was it at the end. There's hooliganism. But your winners. Congratulations to the Anarchists. They will go on to face Fatality for the JCPW Tag Team Championships. But that is the end of the show. We'll see you all next week.